guys, welcome back to my channel. Welcome back for another video. I hope you're doing really well. I keep clapping. I think I'm just excited to be here. I recently filmed one of these videos and I really just enjoyed documenting it, filming it, and giving you guys a little bit more info all about wedding dress shopping. Annoyingly, my camera did cut me off in that video, so it kind of abruptly ended. But since then, I've actually been to two more stores and I've got some vlog footage and some try-on footage of me trying on various dresses. And I just thought it'd be a really good opportunity to sit down again, talk through the two different stores that I went to visit because they're quite different in like price point and designers and just everything, and kind of speak about some of the dresses that I tried on again and also just like overall experiences and thoughts on these two stores. I want to kind of document as much as I can from this whole wedding thing because I just think there's not loads of info out there. I mean, I think there's getting more info out there, but I just want to give you kind of like my experience throughout this whole bridal experience and my thoughts. I will obviously insert the vlog footage like as and when we go, but I just thought it was good to give some context to some of the clips you guys are gonna see.
Hello vlog, welcome back for another bridal related vlog. Today I'm trying out another store. I'm heading to Halo and Wren to try on more wedding dresses, and I've got another wedding dress shop booked tomorrow. My camera battery is flashing at me, but I think I've got a spare one. This is what I've decided to pop on. I never know what to wear. I've actually got my new shoes on. Don't know if you guys can see them, my little Gucci denim slides, denim skirt, white t-shirt, white little jacket. Obviously got my ring on and I've just got my Cartier watch and I'm off to go. Sophie looks very upset with me because she's like, Mummy, where are you going? But I can't wait. I'm really looking forward to today. I want to kind of look for potentially a dress for later on in the evening, and I know I have some friends that have got dresses here, so very excited. I'm going to bring you guys along, and then tomorrow I'm off to the wedding club, which... Hey girlies, I am on my way to Halo and Wren. What's nice about Halo and Wren is I can actually drive there. I mean, I can drive to London, but the part of my car in London is astronomical, whereas I can park on the road here for free, I believe, for an hour and a bit. I think they have a huge variety in this store, but I do think, gosh, I literally had to slow down then. I think they have a huge variety in this store, but I think a lot of them are more of that like slim fit dress, which is not going to be for me. So I definitely want to keep it to the style that I seem to be enjoying, which is something that has a little bit more shape, like it comes out a little bit more. I mean, look, this could all change. I know so many of my friends and people that chop and change, and you think you're going to want one thing and you end up wanting something else. So definitely try on other things, but I've just got a feeling. I think it's always good to go and... I think it's really good to go and try on from loads of different stores, because why not? Also, can we just excuse the situation going on in the back? I've got my dog's bed, her blanket, and then four bags for the charity shop that I need to go and drop off at the charity shop. So please excuse that situation going on.
I'm here, I'm running late. Let's go. Okay, I'm going to start out with the first store that I went and visited, which is called Halo and Wren. This is a store that I'd heard good things about from other girls, actually within like the social media world, that they had been there and they'd said, definitely go. They have a lot of dresses to try on and it's like a good experience there. And I just thought, why not? I actually get my nails done really close to where this bridal place is. I get my nails done at a salon called Glam by Polly. And this shop is like four doors down. So it was also very convenient for me to pop in there. By the way, I am on my phone. How cute is my case? This is Casetify. Just because I need to like refresh my memory what dresses I'm talking about, the experience, hence why I'm on my phone. So yeah, overall, the store was really lovely. It was a really big store. It was the first shop I've been into where there was another bride in there. That doesn't particularly bother me, but I just know some people want the experience to be extremely personal and extremely like one-on-one. So there was like another bride there. We obviously weren't in the same area as in like the changing room area, but when we were on the shop floor picking our dresses, we were near each other. It was a very different kind of experience in there. The lady that helped me was extremely helpful, and I feel like with that store, I didn't love that many of the big wedding dresses, and I started to kind of veer my attention more towards like maybe a second dress option, or like something for my legal ceremony, or something for the night before, etc, etc. Just because I didn't fall in love with a lot of the bigger gowns. But there was another girl in there, and essentially what they do is they give you a little box with like a couple of pegs in, and you go around the store and you clip the pegs onto the dresses. Now I totally get this is so practical and it works so efficiently, both for the girl that's helping you shop and obviously yourself, but there's just an element to that experience that I probably don't feel as like luxury about. You know, at the end of the day, these dresses do start around like £2,000, so you're spending a lot of money no matter what your budget is, and I just feel like you want to feel like it's a really special one-on-one experience. I think it would have been no different if I had sort of gone around, looked at the dresses with my family member, and then sort of said, oh, I like that one, I like that one. I don't know, maybe that's just a personal thing. I guess the benefit of doing that is you don't have someone someone breathing down your neck. And she sort of said that. She was like, I'm giving you the free will to just go and pick whatever you want. And then when we were in the actual changing room, that's when she started pulling in some other dresses. Now, the changing room was a really good sized, big changing room. We were both offered a coffee, a glass of Prosecco, that kind of experience. I believe I paid £30 for my Halo and Ren try on experience. And you do get this back if you choose to purchase a dress from these stores, so just bear that in mind. Yeah, the changing room was really nice. Just me and my mum went. My sister was actually away, so I just thought, let's just take my mum. It was a nice size. There's lots of room to try the dresses on. I felt very comfortable with the lady that I was trying the dresses on, which you have to remember, you do have to feel comfortable with these people. You are stripping down, no bra, in your underwear, in the changing room, just you and this person. So you wanna feel like comfortable with them in the changing room. However, it had no natural daylight downstairs where the changing rooms were. So the actual shop floor was beautiful. It had loads of space. It was all white and bright, but the changing rooms had no natural light, which was a bit of a shame because I'm a weirdo. I like to see things in natural light. This could just be me. I don't know if it is just me. Anyway, they've got loads of designers in there. They've got Grace Love's Lace, Jenny Yu, I want to say. Yeah, they've got some that I've definitely heard of before. So that was obviously like a really nice plus. And I think if you're looking for something more slinky or with like embellishments but tight fitting, this could be the store for you. They also have like really cute accessories like headbands, tiaras, earrings in there, all of that good stuff. So I pulled a few dresses. Let's start with the first dress that I tried on. So the first dress that I tried on was a very kind of classic bridal gown, which I'm yet to try on. So it had kind of like a plunge neckline, it had some mesh under the arms and like across here. When I tried this dress on, me and my mum actually thought this was gonna be my dress. Like, we were 100% convinced that this was my dress in the shop. And we've had a really bad tendency of doing that a lot throughout this experience. I go into a store, we get really caught up in the moment and we're like, that's the dress. And then we walk away and look back at pictures and videos or like sort of get our thoughts together and we're like, it isn't the dress. I just got overwhelmed in there and said that it was. So we've done that a lot throughout this experience. I loved this dress that I tried on. It was just such a classic bridal dress and I think it's beautiful, it's timeless. I just don't think for me it's enough. And I think that was always the case, but I wanted to just, you know, tick off the fact that I tried on this kind of classic design. This did have a split up it, but obviously you could get it altered. One of the things to note about Halo and Ren is they do no alterations in-house. Sorry if you can hear snoring, my dog Sophie is next to me and she's snoring. They do no alterations in-house. You have to find an external alterations person to alter the gown for you, which some people might really like that, some people might not. So just something to note. It did have drama, it had a really nice dramatic train, and it was a beautiful dress, but just upon reflection, like, it definitely isn't my dress. It didn't do enough for me. So moving on to dress number two, again, a very similar dress. There was a limited choice for me to make of that kind of A-line style that had embellishment and beading and all of that stuff. So I went for another classic dress. I actually did really like this. It was strapless, but corseted, so I felt extremely kind of sucked in. I felt like they fitted all of the dresses really well to my body, so I could really visualize what they were gonna look like on the day. This had some pleats either side, and it also had more of like a bra style cup, which I wasn't in love with, but it had really pretty embellishment, like little flowers and pearls on the bodice, and that I thought was stunning. Again, I liked this dress. I thought it was really pretty. I believe this had a split up it as well, which I know is super popular now. I just don't think it was my dress. I just don't think it's the dress for me, but I can appreciate that it's a really pretty dress. Then I did one more dress that was very similar to the first. It is honestly really, really pretty much the same. It just had a neckline that instead of going into like a V, it sort of went down and then across into a square. Very pretty dress, classic bridal, that kind of vibe. If you're looking for that classic, chic, timeless style of dress, which I know every bride wants to be, but this really is like more of that minimalist. They called themselves like a modern bridal store, and I can really see that, but it's still classic. They have some stunning dresses there, and their price points were definitely a lot more appealing than some of the other stores, like the next store that I'm about to talk about. Next up, I tried on a dress that I'm actually not gonna show you guys because I'm thinking of wearing this to my legal ceremony. It was really cute, it's a short dress. I thought it was fun. So next up, I tried on another short dress which had this big bow on the side. Really cute, the bow kind of fell down to the floor. Absolutely love this. But these short dresses were actually really expensive. I think this one was like 1,800 or like 2,200. They were a lot of money for like a short dress that you're gonna wear for a couple of hours that isn't your main wedding dress. So I was a bit like, oh, okay, when I found out the prices of these. This was really cute. You could pin up the bow so that it didn't drag on the floor and then you could release it down, which I really liked. They can also adjust the length on this dress. It had a really nice ruched detail to it. I did really like it. I think I just found it a little bit simple, like it was a plain strapless dress. I think I wanted a bit more on the sleeves, but I think it was cute nonetheless. Next up, I tried on a dress that is way too short for me. I don't even know if I've got a proper video of this. It had like feathers on the bottom and beading, way too short for me. This sample also wasn't the best to try on because loads of the feathers she said had been pulled out and it just didn't look how I imagine it to look when you order it. So yeah, kind of moved on quickly from that one. And then this next dress I thought I was gonna love. It's like a puffball style with like a bra built in kind of bodice situation. It was cute, but I don't know, it looked similar to like Opoly or House of CB, which is absolutely fine, but I would obviously rather buy it from those brands because the price point would be a lot nicer. So I thought it was cute, but then when I look back at the pictures, I'm a bit like, oh, I don't know if I like the bodice section on me. I'm not sure. So then I tried on the first dress again because we really thought that this maybe was going to be my dress. It's not, so I feel very comfortable showing it to you guys. I feel like throughout this whole experience I've been like, I don't want to show them this one or this one or this one because they're all contenders. Now I pretty much, I'm like 99% sure on what dress I'm picking. I feel very confident to show you this and say it's not my dress. But she was close. She was close to being the dress. And overall, we had a really nice experience. I'd definitely recommend it. They have a huge variety in there. I feel like the lady that helped us was really, really nice. All of the sample sizes were a really good size. I didn't feel like any of them were too small on me. That's my biggest fear as a bride, going into a bridal store and trying on a dress that's in like a UK 4. And just, I felt like it just being really, really small on me. I feel like you want it to fit you how you think it's gonna fit you on the day. So yeah, I had overall good experience. I think this shop is definitely more suited to girls that maybe want that slim fitting, tight to dress. I think you're gonna find something here, but for me that's not what I'm after, so we move on. These appointments were a day apart, which was really nice. I really recommend doing that. I know it's quite a lot to do like two stores in one day, or like one on the Monday and one on the Tuesday, but if you can, I would, because everything's so fresh in your mind. Take as many photos and videos as you can, get other people to take photos and videos from different angles so you can see how these dresses are gonna look when you come away from the store. It's quite an overwhelming experience in those stores, and I feel like you're not thinking how you actually want to think. Sometimes you can get very caught up in the situation. They add a veil and you're like, it's the one, she's saying yes to the dress, but it might not be the one. So yeah, that's my kind of piece of advice. Hello girly girls, how are we doing? I am off again today to try on wedding dresses. I've just got to check my phone because I've just called my Uber. Oh, he's arrived. Amazing. And I'm going to the wedding club and I'm going to bring you guys along. I can't wait. I've got a really cute outfit on, but I will show you when we get to London. This dress is House of CB. And then I'm going to take out my little Lady Dior, because do you know what? It's a special day. We're going to try on wedding dresses. It's like my favourite thing to do at the moment. I never want this to end. So yeah, let's go see how the day goes. I'm very excited for this one. Hello guys. So we are on the way. We're about to hit back on. God, hope not. Just me and Vanessa today. Here she is.
It's just the two of us.
In our summer dresses. I didn't know what jacket to bring. You brought a denim jacket.
Oh,
I was a bit confused.
It was too early
for
me
to decide. Yeah. Yeah, so we're on our way to the wedding club. I think there's a couple of these. There's one in Birmingham and there's two in London. I think they've washed the floor here. There's a lot going on. But yeah, let's see how we get on. I ended up going to the wedding club. They have two stores, one in South Ken and one in Knightsbridge. They're very close to each other. I went to the store in Knightsbridge. Every single store has different designs. So just take, they also have a store in Birmingham. Take a little look online at the stores and the designers that are stocked there and you'll get a vibe for what you want. So for instance, a lot of people up in Birmingham way don't have Suzanne Neville, like their own store, whereas obviously I live close to London and I can go directly to Suzanne Neville. However, the wedding club stock multiple designers and they stock Suzanne Neville in their Birmingham store. So it kind of depends what designer you want. I actually went to an event at the wedding club a long time ago now for a Berta collection, and Berta dresses are simply, but again, they're a designer that are priced at a slightly higher price point. So do your research when it comes to the wedding club and have a little look. Go in with the idea that their dresses really range in price. And luckily, I sort of said early on in the appointment, by the way, I really don't want to go over this price point, even though we did kind of slightly go over the price point. But that's another situation, because you can really, really run away in there. Like, there were dresses in there that were £25,000. So yes. Yes, there were dresses in there for £25,000. So just please bear that in mind and just like get that information out at your appointment if that's something that concerns you. Once I'd got out what I don't want to go over, I never asked the price of the dresses until I'd finished the appointment, because when I was trying them on, I didn't want that to cloud my judgment. I just wanted to try them on. If I liked one, brilliant. If I didn't, no, and move like that. But that's because I'd already set what I definitely didn't want to go over. But obviously you can do it based on however it works for you. Love this store in Knightsbridge. This store at the wedding club is a beautiful shop. It has really big bright windows with loads of natural light. We were the only people in there, so it was my mum and me and obviously the lady that helped us, which again I really appreciated. It just felt very personal and just like the three of us. She never sort of pushed me for time or anything like that, which was really nice. I've been to other stores where they have sort of said, you've got 15 minutes now, you need to finish your appointment. It was a very early morning appointment, but we did still have a glass of Prosecco, which is nice. We've never turned down a glass of Prosecco at a single one of these appointments. Does that say something about us? I think it does. There were some designers in here that I've been desperate to try. There's been some dresses that I've been desperate to try. I don't want to go too much into it because I just don't want to give away my dress, but this was a fantastic experience. I felt incredible in here. I want to show you guys some of the dresses. So I can't show you the first dress that I tried because it was so beautiful. So yeah, I'm not going to show you that. I actually tried the first dress on with a veil and it was stunning. Same goes for the second dress. I'm not going to show you that. I think I've ruled it out, but I'm not 100%, so I'm not going to show you it. I am going to show you the third dress. I believe this dress is a Berta dress, and it's incredible. The beading and the craftsmanship on this dress was simply stunning. The train was beautiful. It had a split up it. The only thing that put me off was parts of it were quite see-through, and I don't think on my wedding day I want that. I mean, who knows? Maybe I'll change my mind. It had a lovely corset, so I felt very kind of like sucked in. We were going to kind of play around with the straps and do some alterations. That's one of the things I would rave about the wedding club for. They were very hands-on when it came to alterations, and like, we can slightly change this and we can slightly do that and we can move this here and we can add the lace there and we can add the beading there. She was constantly saying to me things that I could change with each dress, and I loved that because it just felt very like they were fitting the dress to you, and it was just really, really nice. Oh, this is stunning, and if I wanted something like this aesthetic, I actually think I probably would have said yes to this dress. It's so stunning, and when I look at the pictures, I'm like, oh my god, I do really love it. So yeah, blew me away. It was beautiful. I had to try on some of the Berta dresses. I couldn't say no, but it's not the style that I think I want to go for. I think it's a stunning dress. I don't think it's the one for me, which makes me a bit sad to say because it's beautiful. Okay, I'm going to show you the next dress because otherwise I've got like no dresses to show you from the wedding club because they're all contenders. This I've recently ruled out, so I feel comfortable showing you it. It was beautiful. Again, a Berta dress, strapless with added sleeves, so you could remove the sleeves or add the sleeves. You could also alter the sleeves to make them more tight-fitting or loose. So in these clips, they're quite loose because I wanted that kind of boho feel to the dress. I've since kind of done a bit of a sharp bend away from the boho vibe, but I did think this was beautiful. Just even the little details that the lady in there mentioned, there's like a little kind of flat bit where there's no detail on the top of the cup. She was like, we can add detail here, we can move the lace and add it up here. It was just, she was fantastic. This dress had a bit of everything. It had a dramatic train, dramatic sleeves, a corset. It had like detachable sleeves. There was so much going on. I do think it's spectacular and I love it, but there were others that I loved more, which I cannot believe I'm saying that, but there were others that I loved more, and I'm not going to show you those because they were all contenders. Fantastic experience, thoroughly enjoyed my time at the wedding club. Loved just the overall store itself and all the natural light. That was something that I thought was a really like good plus. So yeah, those are my overall kind of review and experiences of the stores that I have been to so far. I've done four stores, I've reviewed all four. I'll leave my other video where I talk about wedding dresses in the description box below if you do want to watch that video. I'm thinking I'm going to go to one more store. I think I'm going to go to Galeries Le Havre. They're opening a store in August. Their dresses look beautiful. I'm curious. So I think I might go there, but I'm pretty certain on what my dress is. So yeah, I think I am going to go there and try on a few more dresses because I never want this experience to end. It's been so much fun. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Let me know in the comment section if you want to hear any more bridal updates from me. I hope you guys are all doing super well. Don't forget to follow me on Instagram and TikTok for more bridal tips, tricks, all of that good stuff. And I will see you all in my next video. Bye guys.